Welcome to the Full Nelson. Today I'm reviewing the Smith and Wesson 2.0 compact. This particular model is chambered in 9mm, and I'm going to be comparing it to the Glock 19. This particular model is a Gen 4 model, and it is also chambered 9mm. Now, the first thing I want to talk about with these handguns is the trigger. In my opinion, the triggers on these handguns are pretty much a wash. The Smith and Wesson has a slightly lighter trigger pull. The Glock pulls further forward within the trigger guard than the Smith & Wesson. I'll see if I can show you that. Let's get an up-close thing here. So in the Glock, it pulls, and you hit the wall about there, breaks there, okay? Smith & Wesson hits the wall right there, pulls back here. Now, the thing, it probably looks like they're breaking them out in the same area, but notice how thin the trigger is on the Smith & Wesson. So when it breaks, look at your finger, feels like it's back substantially further than on something like the Glock, probably just because of the thickness of that trigger. I actually prefer the feel of the Glock trigger in terms of where it breaks further. It feels further forward in the trigger guard than the Smith & Wesson does. I actually like that or prefer that on the Glock 19. With that said, the Smith & Wesson's trigger pull is slightly lighter. So for a newcomer, they're probably gonna find it easier to shoot the Smith & Wesson well in terms of the trigger because of it being a little bit lighter. So triggers between these two handguns, I'd say, are a wash. You can learn to shoot either one fine. You may prefer one over the other, but in my opinion, I could shoot either one of them comparably well. So the triggers in these, I'd say, are washed. The sights, as they come from the factory. Smith & Wesson comes with nice three-dot sights from the factory. Okay. Glocks come with their crappy plastic sights from the factory. So guess what I replace them with? Nice metal three-dot sights. The Smith & Wesson comes with those already from the factory. So yeah, no need to replace those on the Smith & Wesson. There is one thing I don't particularly like about the metal Smith & Wesson sights, which is just a minor improvement I think they could make. Some people may like this, maybe for, you know, the purpose of holstering or whatever they do this, but I'll show you this compared to these metal Trigicons I have on this Glock. Look at the shape of these sights. You see how they're kind of sloped? I mean, I guess they kind of have a little bit of an edge to them, and then they're sloped up. Now look at this. See how those are just a straight notch squared off? I know these might not look as slick, but from a functionality perspective, there are some advantages to having squared off sights like that. If I need to rack this gun one-handed against a belt or anything, I can take this thing, jam it in, and rack it, no problem. And you can probably do that on the Smith & Wesson. Yeah, I can kind of do it. But it's not nearly as easy because of the fact that they have decided to taper these. That's a mistake, in my opinion. Just leave them square. And you'll have that additional level of functionality to be able to operate your handgun one-handed if for some reason you needed to do that. So, but as they come from the factory, the Smith & Wesson definitely has better sights. With that being said, not perfect. I do see room for improvement. Please make them squared off so that they so that you can operate the thing one-handed. Just a minor suggestion there. Now, grip. This has been one of the big issues for me in the past with Smith & Wesson and with Glock, for that matter, as well. The third-gen Glocks, which I owned a few of, had no texturing to speak of, really, on the grips. They just felt really slick, uncomfortable to hold in your hand. Then with the fourth gen and the fifth gen that's out now, they have this texturing. You can see that stippling there. Anyway, this texturing actually adds quite a bit in terms of what it feels like in your hand over the older ones that had no texturing to speak of. I really like that. Smith & Wesson, with their original Gen 1 or whatever Smith & Wesson, or their original Smith & Wesson M&Ps didn't have any texturing really either, or not any texturing I would consider to be adequate, which is one of the reasons why I always stuck with the fourth gen Glocks over the Smith and Wessons. Well, now they've come out with the 2.0 Smith and Wessons, and they have fixed that. And in fact, they have gone a level above what Glock's doing. This texturing here is phenomenal. The camera probably just won't do it justice, but it is absolutely phenomenal. When you grab onto that, it is like having Talon grips on your handgun from the factory. It's like sandpaper. I mean, it is just excellent. Excellent, gives you an excellent purchase. So as far as the grip design, the way they come from the factory, most people are going to prefer the grip angle on the Smith & Wesson over the Glock. I actually find that grip angle of slightly less tapered grip angle easier for me to shoot well than the Glock, and I've shot Glocks more than probably any other handgun. I still find it easier for me to shoot well with that grip angle. The grip itself, as far as the texture and stuff, feels better on the Smith & Wesson, so I'd give the nod in the grip department to the Smith & Wesson over the Glock at this point. Now, the disassembly. Both of these guns are super easy to disassemble. For any of those of you out there who may be concerned, these have already been safety checked prior to this video numerous times before I even sat down to shoot this. So don't worry, these are totally safe. To disassemble a Glock, and this, they're about as simple as it gets for disassembly, remove the magazine. Of course, you need to make sure the weapon's clear. I guess I'll do that so that you people can see that. Check, make sure there's no bullets, no magazine, no nothing. Then you can dry fire this thing. So what you do is you grab with this hand here, pull these two little tabs down. Let me get you a little closer so you can see these. You've got these little tabs on both sides. While you're holding it with your one hand, you take, push those tabs down, then fire, and it comes apart. Okay? To reassemble it, you just make sure that this spring is seated properly. Slide it back on, it's reassembled. Smith & Wesson is not bad by any means to disassemble at all either. I would certainly not buy one of these guns over the other because of the disassembly. They both have that figured out. Great design. Slide it back. You press this little button up to lock it. Then you grab this little tab, turn it down, release that. Then you depress the trigger, and it comes off. Okay. To reassemble it, you still make sure this thing's down, put your slide back on, press that button up to lock it in place, just like we did before, to take it off, push that thing back down, it's reassembled, okay? So that's how you disassemble and reassemble both of these. In the disassembly department, the Glock is probably slightly better than the Smith & Wesson. It's just a little bit simpler. Certainly not a reason why I would buy or sell either one of them. They're both super simple to disassemble. Shootability. I find this to be another area where it's pretty much a wash for me. I can shoot either one of these handguns equally well. I do have a lot more experience shooting Glocks than I do Smith & Wessons. So the fact that I can shoot the Smith & Wesson just as good as a Glock 19, or any of the Glocks for that matter, any of the full-size, whatever, really goes to show that the Smith & Wesson, for a newcomer, they would probably find it to be more shootable between the grip angle and the trigger. They're probably going to have an easier time getting to where they're proficient shooting it well than they would with a Glock. That's my opinion on that. Now, the value. This is where the Smith & Wesson just absolutely destroys Glock. Fourth gen Glocks right now, I think, are selling around $500 or so. Fifth gen Glocks are like $550 to $600. The Smith & Wesson can be had for, I believe, $450 to $500. Has better sights from the factory. A little bit better trigger, probably, for most people. For me, it's wash because I do prefer it breaking further forward. But for any newcomer, I suspect you're probably going to prefer the trigger on the Smith & Wesson. So better sights on the Smith & Wesson from the factory, probably a trigger that's just as good or better for most people. The grip is better on the Smith & Wesson. Disassembly, I guess, is slightly better for the Glock. Shootability is equally good, in my opinion. But for a newcomer, probably find the Smith & Wesson a little bit easier to shoot well. And it's cheaper. So all around, it's just a better value. I'm a huge Glock fan. I love Glocks. I still carry Glocks to this day, partly because that's what I already owned. I haven't seen a compelling enough reason to change from one to the other. I seem to shoot them, either one of them, just as well as the other. And between Glock, Smith and Wesson, a lot of the Palmer frame guns, my Glocks have never let me down. It just happened to be the first thing I bought, and I own enough of them now and enough extra magazines and 33 round mags and all this stuff that I don't really see a compelling reason to change. With that being said, you'd be foolish not to see that Smith & Wesson's offering has some major advantages over Glock between the value department and all the other things I've already mentioned. So that concludes my review of the Smith & Wesson Compact, Smith & Wesson 2.0 Compact in 9mm. It is a better value than a Glock, no doubt about it. You just can't argue with that. It's a phenomenal handgun. It's kind of like when I compared the Shield to a Glock 43. If they were the same price, I actually like some of the things on the Glock 43. The grip, to me, feels a little bit better on the 43 than the Smith & Wesson M&P Shield. But with that being said, you just can't argue with the fact that the Shield is a better value than the Glock is. So we're kind of seeing things shift in the handgun market. This has been going on for the last several years, that people are starting to realize that while Glocks used to be the top dog, there are a lot of companies that are still willing to innovate and improve, where Glock just refuses to do some basic things like put decent sights on your gun from the factory, not Palmer sights. They got rid of the finger grooves on the 5th gen, which is good, but then they added this stupid notch right up here in front of the thing. I will never buy one because of that. I mean, there are some things like that that if they were willing to simply change some things a little bit, you know, they could still be competitive, but they refuse to do some of that. So I suspect we'll continue to see companies like Smith & Wesson and others that are willing to actually innovate continue to take more and more of the market share away from Glock, and with good reason from what I'm seeing. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those in the comments section below. Have a nice day.